This is the Sales Babble Podcast, episode 254, How Chatbots Are Transforming Sales, an interview with Dave Gerhardt.
Welcome to Sales Babble, the podcast that shares selling secrets for non-sellers. And now your host, Pat Helmers.
Hello, sales babblers. This is Pat Helmers. And today we're going to pick up where we left off last week. If you remember last week, we had Rod Foyer on here and he talked about playbooks for reps. He would give advice to reps on what to say and when to say it and things like that, and ways to automate that so they could be able to have the answer just at the tip of their tongue. But today we're going to go a step further because I think there was a study along the lines about 5 years ago that says 65% of the sale happens on the website before they ever call a sales rep up, and it's probably a lot more now. Picture the possibility of bumping that number up even higher. Our guest today is Dave Gerhardt. He's the Vice President of Sales and Marketing for Drift.com. Have you ever been on a website where you've seen a little chatbot pop up and say, do you have any questions or anything I can do to help? That's what we're going to talk about today. So did you watch the Super Bowl on Sunday? Did you notice how many ads there were for robots taking over our lives or moving into our society? Well, that's not going to happen in sales anytime quickly. But I think it's really interesting to see what artificial intelligence is doing here in 2019. So with no further ado, let's get to it. Welcome, Dave. Are you ready to babble?
I am. I was born to babble. I'm ready.
Terrific. Dave, my background's computer science, and years and years ago, I was very interested in expert systems and artificial intelligence, and a lot of that kind of like got pushed aside. A lot of people try to push that technology as far as they go, but it just wasn't quite there. But I'm seeing with Watson that there's a lot more possibility here. We're seeing cars being automated, blue-collar workers being put out of work. Are white-collar workers going to be the next thing? And then when I bumped into Drift.com, I got thinking about, well, maybe this has something to do with sales. Maybe we should all be polishing our resume and finding a different job.
Unfortunately, you're still going to have to work. But I think it's for the better, and I'm excited to talk to you and tell more, because I think there is a big change happening, and I think it's super interesting, especially for, you know, sales pros, especially traditional sales pros, for sure.
So maybe you could share a little bit about what Drift is, so our listeners are probably going, well, what kind of automation is Pat talking about?
Yeah, so we make marketing and sales software. We call it conversational marketing, and it's really all connecting you now with the people who are interested in your business now, as opposed to traditional marketing and sales is all about, hey, come to my website, fill out this form, and somebody's going to reach out to you later. Everything you and I do in our real lives now, and like real life meaning like, you know, after 9 to 5, we expect the answers now, and so we built a marketing and sales platform that does exactly that, connects you now with the people who are ready to buy from you now.
So it's kind of more similar to, you know, if I think of a retail store, you know, people walk in the door, they shop around, they pick something out, talk to the store clerk. Clerk says, right this way to the checkout.
Exactly. And so I love that analogy, because here's the crazy part. This is how like a B2B, if a B2B company had that example, this is how it works. You walk into the store, there's a bunch of people working there, but you're just like wandering around the store aimlessly and nobody helps you. And then you leave the store, and the second you leave the store, your phone rings and it's like, hey, Patrick, thanks for stopping by my store earlier. Anyway, and you're like, wait a second, why didn't this guy just talk to me while I was in his store 5 minutes ago? And so that's the big opportunity that we see. That's what we think is broken about most businesses today, is they ignore you when you're on their website, and then all the marketing and selling to you starts after, as opposed to what you want to happen in a store. I want to walk in your store and I want somebody to walk up to me and say, hey, I'm here if you have any questions. Let me know if you need any help.
Well, I'm really skeptical about this whole thing right off the get-go.
Good.
Because I come from enterprise sales background, B2B, takes lots of meetings. No one's going to walk out of the door. No one's going to walk out of the store with this right away. This is these commonly require a lot of people to be involved in the decision. So you can see where I'm like, well, this sounds good, but I don't buy it.
Yeah. So look. So I understand your skepticism coming from the enterprise sales world, and this is a question we get a lot. And I actually think I actually kind of have the opposite take on this, which I agree with you that there is more process, and it does take multiple meetings, and you do have to sell to many people inside of an organization. But I actually think getting a meeting today is a miracle. Like, it's nothing short of a miracle. You and I are all so busy. I can find out, like, A, I'm so busy. There's a million channels. I can't keep up with anything. Slack, email, chat. There's too many channels. On top of that, information is free now. So even if it is an enterprise company, I can find out anything I need to know about your business without ever having to talk to anybody there. Almost anything. And I'll use one example I think about. My wife and I, a month ago, we bought a new car. I didn't walk into the dealership and say, show me some cars. What's good here? Like, I did all my research, and I basically had 90% of the buying process done. And I walked into the store and I said, look, I don't want you to sell to me. I know exactly what I want. I want to test drive this one. I want to compare to this one. And that completely changes the sales process. And I think that's what's happening with businesses now too, is you as a – if you're in sales or if you're in marketing, like, you can't treat somebody like they don't know anything about your business. They've asked two other people who've used it. They've read reviews online. They've watched tutorials. They've seen somebody speak. They've listened to your podcast. They've read your blog. They've done all this research and gotten all this information, and then they're talking to you. Versus, I think the big change a decade ago was there wasn't any of that information, and so the only way to find it was to actually talk to a salesperson.
Yeah, and there was a famous study done quite a while ago, maybe 5 years ago, that said that 65% of the sale happens online before they ever talk to a salesperson. It's probably more now, because that was quite a while ago.
Yep. And so I think the change there is just like, look, I agree with you about the multiple meetings thing, but I think the change is just now in that process, if I know this is going to take time, then I want you to be even more consultative and helpful than you might even be regularly, right? Because, hey, look, this is going to take 3 months. I really need your help. I need you to be on my team and basically help me sell this into my company. And so I think the way that Drift fits into this is it's all about removing all of the barriers from the right person to having a conversation with your business. And so if you know somebody's a good fit and you know they're interested in your company, why send them through all these hoops and gates and forms just to talk to somebody?
Well, I think a lot of this is there's been a lot of people aren't very comfortable with the telephone, which I find mystifying. Like the other day, I talked to a sales rep, and I really wanted to talk to somebody, so I picked up the phone and I called him, and somebody answered immediately, just like you spoke about. I walked into the store, and there was a clerk standing right there, right at the phone, right, answered all my questions. I almost feel like generationally, there's a sense of like, oh, I better not call anybody up. Let's see what I can do on my phone by texting, right?
Yep.
As opposed to just, right, the phone number's right there on the website. Call me. So why doesn't the phone work?
I think the phone would. I honestly think the phone would work. But here's my problem with the phone is, I think something like local dial is ruining the phone for us. Where do you know what local? Do you familiar with local dial?
That's where people, it looks like they're local, but they're not.
Yeah. And so like, even when I think it's somebody, so I'm in Boston, and the two, and where I'm from, the two familiar area codes are 508 and 774. And so 2 years ago, if it was a 508 number, I'd be like, oh, this is somebody from home. I'm going to answer it. Now people know that that's where I'm from. And so I get calls that are basically spam calls from those numbers. And so really I think the challenge with the phone is the only time I answer the phone now is if I know the person. So it's got to be somebody that's already in my contact, you know, list. And so I think that's the challenge of the phone. I don't think it's that people are afraid to talk on the phone. I think it's that the hit rate on the phone is so low that, you know, people don't want to make 100 calls to only get one connection.
Yeah, well, that's a whole different thing. They don't need to. It's, you know, by doing social selling, there's things you can do to bump up that rate. You know, I was thinking more in the context of, like you said, when people come to your website, and maybe we're getting off track here, but if people come to your website and there's a 1-800 number on there, that seems like a pretty fair thing to call. And you have an inside sales, you know, or an SDR kind of group, you would think they'd pick the phone up and say, hey, this is Acme. How can I help you?
Yep, I agree.
But that's not how this works, is it? How does this work?
Well, so this we have nothing to do with the phone, right? The way conversational marketing works is, look, you have a website, right? Every business today has a website. people are walking into that website, your store, every single day, and nobody's talking to them.
Right.
And so especially in the B2B enterprise world, like nobody is on that website for fun, right? You and I are not laying in bed on a Saturday morning casually browsing a B2B enterprise company's website, right? Like, I am on that website for a reason. And so the whole pitch is go out and talk to those people, right? And so, sure, maybe there's a different sales motion where you're going to need to send outbound emails and make some cold calls. But, you know, we're going to help you capture more of the people that are already walking into your store that traditionally would have either gotten ignored or been forced to fill out a form and have somebody come back and follow up with them 5 days later when the opportunity is gone.
So how does this mechanically work? So I visit a website. What happens?
So you visit – so there's two – so in most cases it works like this. You visit a website. While you're browsing the website, you see a little bot in the bottom right-hand corner of the website.
Yep.
And it says, hey there, I'm here if you have any questions, right? Sort of exactly like somebody would if they were in your store. That's V1, very basic kind of wide application. But below that, there's a million different ways you can customize and target that. And so let's say I know that we are right now having a conference in San Francisco, and I want people that are coming to my website from San Francisco to see a certain message. Then I can target that message based on all that context. Or you're on a specific page. You're on my pricing page. I can have a message that says, hey, have questions about our pricing? Did you know that right now you can get this and this? And so basically you can customize any conversation based on any of the context on your website, whether that is where they came from, which page they're on, or even activities they've already done on the website. So I'll give you one example is we have a blog. We create a lot of content. The blog would be kind of a weird place to ask for a demo because most people reading the blog don't want to be sold to. But if it's somebody who's visited the blog 5 times, after the 5th visit, the bot will pop out and say, hey, looks like you come here a lot. Can I show you how Drift works? Do you want to get a demo? And so it's all about sending the right message at the right time based on all that context.
So lots of times I'll come to these websites and I'll see that and I'll ask, yes, I do have a question. And they'll say, well, nobody's here right now.
Right.
So how does it address that? We're talking about just having a human being on the other side.
Yeah. So you can either have a human being or a bot. The bot, our bot has gotten good enough now where you can actually program it to serve up the right answer. So you don't need somebody to be there. And I think that one thing that we see across so many websites is 90% of the questions are the same, right? Like I know having been at Drift for a couple years now, like people that come to our website, they usually ask kind of like 1 of 5 questions. And so machines are getting really smart and we can help them we can say, hey, here are the most common asked questions and the bot can actually serve up that answer. And so if somebody says, hey, are you guys going to be at that trade show in Boston next week? Yes, actually we are. Here's a link if you want to register. Or I'm trying to find pricing for blah, blah, blah. Yes, actually, here it is. And so there's a lot of like – we kind of think of it as like digital paperwork, and that's where we want to use bots to automate some of that stuff. There's always going to be questions that humans are better at answering and people want to talk to humans for. But we think that a bot can handle all that digital paperwork so you as a sales rep can focus on what you're good at, which is selling, not kind of answering all those like mundane questions that people might have as they visit your website.
So by digital paperwork, you mean giving people the right brochures when they ask them?
Yeah, giving people the right brochures and when they ask them the right information. Hey, how much does this cost, or does it integrate with this? We can the bot can serve up almost all of those answers, and then you can save the questions for human when you really need something. Like, yes, I am actually interested in buying this car. Okay, great. Let me grab Dave. He's available right now, and he can talk to you.
So are these like pre-written decision trees, or is this really AI? Or like,
it's both. And so the basic version is you can make pre-written decision trees, and you can really quickly learn what people want just by kind of watching them on your site. But the bot, our bot is powered by AI and machine learning, and is able to learn and start to understand some of those things. And over time, that's where we're really betting heavily on at Drift is. Bots are getting so good and so smart where we can serve up a lot of that content without having to put a human there. Now, the flip side of that is humans can add a ton of value, and I actually think they can do a better job because the sales rep is oftentimes going to have a little bit more context than the bot will. And so when we talk about that, a lot of people say, yeah, but how am I ever going to – do you expect my sales reps to just sit there all day and answer questions? And in some questions, I kind of say, yeah, because what more high value conversation is there? Somebody's on your website that wants to talk to your sales team, right? But most people say, oh, my reps are too busy. Well, these are the best people you could be talking to in the world.
I know a lot of people would just they would die. They would love it so much if people just called them up and said, I'm interested in maybe buying.
Exactly.
I have to do any work? No, they're just going to call you up. Oh, my goodness. I don't have to call. I don't have to do outbound. No.
Nope. And you talk to any rep, they don't care if it's 9:30 at night. And so that's where the cool part about Drift is. You can have an app on your phone. And so, you know, I could put my daughter to bed and just be laying on the couch, and I could get a push notification on my phone that says, hey, the SVP of marketing at American Express is on the website now. Do you want to talk to her? Heck yeah, I want to talk to her. And then within one click, I'm on my phone and I can have a conversation with that person who's on my website.
So how did you know their demographics?
There's a reverse IP lookup functionality that we have inside of Drift where we can know, you know, if that person is on a company's IP address or if they've come to the website at any time before and given us their email, we will be able to identify them.
Hmm. Creepy and cool.
Yeah, I mean, I get it. Creepy, but it's not any. It's not
it's,
any of your.
It's kind of cool it's not, too.
It's like, it's cool. It's yeah. None of your personal. It's none of your personal information. It's information about your company and your business, and what it does is, it removes the barrier to have a conversation, as opposed to most websites. You have to say, in order to talk to somebody, you have to say, here's my company. Here's my job title. Here's how many employees we have. Here's what industry we're in. Here's how much revenue we're doing. And then I get the permission to talk to you.
Yeah. Interesting. Super interesting stuff. Can you listen to what is it possible you could have software like watch a real human and work on the chat on your chat line for like a month and then actually like parse all that what's coming in and then generate answers from that? I'm seeing reoccurring patterns because I feel that way with Google. When I do my Gmail, it's like seeing the styles that I answer my questions, and they're just replicating back by giving me hints on like, you want to finish the sentence this way, which I find is kind of creepy but cool.
Yeah, no, you're so right. So yeah, we one really like underrated thing that you can do is let it run for a month. You can export just into a spreadsheet all of those things, all those questions, and you can start to filter through. And you can say, "Whoa, you know, we really need to write an FAQ for this because everyone asked this and we don't have the answer." So it's a great way to really understand what's happening and where people are getting stuck and hung up on your website.
And would it automatically be creating its own script, or is it? Or there's still you still be typing this out in a decision tree kind of manner?
Yeah, you would for as of now, you would have to the way it works today, you would have to then go take what you learned and go and update it. But I could definitely see in the future where this can get really smart and start to learn some of that stuff for you.
Yeah. So I have mixed opinions here. I'd like to see it at that level of Westworld. You know. But at the same time, that can be really dangerous.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah. You mentioned we were talking earlier before, or actually, I was talking with was it Lacey? She says you guys are launching a book this week.
Yes, Wednesday we wrote. So good timing is we've spent the last 2 years kind of writing the book on conversational marketing. We've learned a ton from. There's over 150,000 businesses that are using Drift and kind of doing what we've just talked about, and we want to help reach a broader audience. And so we spent time over the last 2 years kind of putting all these thoughts and playbooks and tactics into this book. And so the official book on conversational marketing is coming out Wednesday. It's going to be everywhere: Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Target. I've seen it in a million stores already, and super excited to get that out to everybody.
Will, how can people find you guys online?
Drift.com is the easiest way. Come over to drift.com and then we're Drift on basically all social media.
Why Drift? How'd you get that name?
The founders came up with it, really. That's it. That's a secret. But they named the company Drift 4 or 5 years ago, and the way that we think about it is the future of sales and marketing is about customers being able to drift from one conversation to another, as opposed to the old way, which is you got to follow these five steps, this linear funnel, in order to talk to somebody, right? It's now people come in from Twitter, they come in from Instagram, they come in from LinkedIn or email or outbound or cold call or whatever. Conversations happen everywhere, and drift is the piece that sits right in the middle.
Hmm. So interesting. How can people find you online, Dave?
I'm at Dave Gerhardt, G-E-R-H-A-R-D-T, everywhere, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter. Try to post a lot of stuff there, and you can find me on any of those places.
Yeah, I see, too, that you're giving away Justin Timberlake tickets.
We are. We're giving away Justin Timberlake tickets. If you're in New York on book launch day, then we'll see you there. So.
Yeah, that would be Wednesday. That's 2 days from now. I'm not certain when this is going to be published. So people are probably going to miss out on that opportunity.
Yeah, that's okay. We'll be there. We'll have a bunch of photos to send you after.
Cool. All right. Well, Dave, thank you very much for coming here to Sales Babble and babbling with us. I really, really appreciate it. This is a terrific topic.
Hey, thank you for having me. Good luck. Stay warm out there, and good luck to you. I'll see you soon.
So what do you think? Are you ready for the robots to come and take all our jobs? Nah, I think it's going to take a while before that happens. So to connect with Dan and Drift.com, you can find links in the show notes at www.salesbabble.com/254. I'm sorry, but you missed the free tickets for Justin Timberlake. Maybe I can help you out.
You ready, JT?
I can't wait till I get you on for good looking.
That's all I got for this week. Until next, take care and have a highly successful and a profitable selling day.
Thank you for listening to the Sales Babble podcast. Find us at www.salesbabble.com.
And as long as I got my suit and tie, I'm gonna leave it all on the floor tonight. And you got fixed up tooth and eyes, let me show you a few things. All dressed up in black and white, and you're dressed in that dress I like.